Morning students, in previous video we discussed about different example of physiological adaptations, okay, and today also we will discuss a few other examples. There are many organisms, you can find out they are living in areas where the temperature is very high. For example, you go to desert, you can find out the temperature that is beyond normal temperature. And you know that all enzymes, they work at a temperature range of 35 to 40 degrees centigrade. So if the temperature will be more than 40 degrees centigrade temperature, then also problems will arise. And if the temperature will be very low, then also the enzymes, they will not be able to work. And you know that inside the living body, all metabolic pathways, they are operated only in the presence of enzyme. There is no pathway which is operated without enzymes. In chemistry, the chemical reactions, they can be operated in the presence or absence of catalyst. But in the living organism's body, it is not possible because the rate will be very, very slow. Okay? But if the temperature is very high, for example, suppose you take some bacteria which can survive in hot spring. In hot spring, boiling water is there and the temperature, so that is 100 degrees centigrade. So in 100 degrees centigrade, how bacteria is able to survive? So, because they are having the enzymes which are called thermostable enzyme. Okay, while explaining the biotechnology chapter also, I had explained you that we are separating TAC polymerase enzymes from bacteria, archibacteria, and that enzyme that is used in PCR technique. So, those bacteria, they are having the enzymes which are called thermostable enzyme, and these enzymes, they can work at a temperature of 100 degrees centigrade. So that is the reason why these bacteria, they are able to survive in hot spring. Then similarly, you can find out there are many areas where the temperature, so that is in minus. If you go to polar area, you go to the Antarctica, you can find out the temperature, so that is in minus degree. Okay. So those kind of organisms, they are also having the enzymes which are called anti-freezing enzymes. Even in the low temperature also, the enzymes, they will not freeze and they will work like the normal enzyme. So the organism, they are able to survive in the area where extreme temperature is there or where very low temperature is also there. Now another kind of adaptation, so that is behavioral adaptation. By changing the behavior, how the organism, they are able to survive. For example, you take the example of desert lizard. There are many reptiles, or even the dogs also, you have seen that during the winter they take sun bath. Okay, now similarly the lizards, they are also taking the sun bath, which is called basking, sun basking. So if the temperature will be low, body temperature will be low, because these are all the poikilothermal animals or the organism, and their temperature will change as per the temperature of the surroundings. So when there is low temperature, they lie in the sun so that they can take the sun and the body temperature will rise. So when the body temperature will rise beyond the normal temperature, again they are escaping and they are going to the shade. So by changing the behavior, they are able to adjust the temperature of the body. Or you have seen that some animals, they are also burrowing into the soil. So if there is either extreme temperature, either very hot or the very cold, then they are entering into the hole of the burrow, and the whole unfavorable conditions, they are remaining there so that they can protect themselves. So this is called behavioral adaptation. So now we will discuss about population attributes. So you try to understand what is the meaning of the population and what is the meaning of attributes. Population is group of individuals. So either we are talking about one single individual, or when we are talking about a group of individuals, then we call it as population. And the attribute means characters. So what are the characters of population? So the population, that is a group of individuals which are found in the same area, they are using the same resources, and also they are interbreeding among themselves. Okay, so they are crossing, or the mating, so that is taking place between either the same species or the different species of that particular same area, and they reproduce either asexually or asexually. In both conditions, we call the group of individuals as population. So, population ecology, that is a branch of the ecology which is studying about the ecological concept of population. Because the population, that is living in a particular area. And the area, so that area is having so many factors, so many there in that particular area. And all of you know that there is always a relationship between the abiotic and the biotic component of any ecosystem. Okay, so it is linking ecology to population, genetics and evolution. Because you know that the evolution, so that is a continuous process which is also taking place in the population, and by the process of the evolution you can see new species over the time period is developing in that particular area. Okay, so now we will discuss about what are the attributes or properties of a population. Number one is the birth rate and death rate, and number two, so that is the sex ratio. Okay, so when we are talking about an individual, then we can see as the birth and death. Okay, but when you are talking about the population, then we are using the word, so that is the birth rate or death rate. Okay, so you will get numerical question. In both exams, we will get the numerical question. The question will be given, you have to find out the birth rate or the death rate. For example, suppose you take a pond, and the pond total number of the lotus plants are 20. So that is the size of the population. And in 1 year, 8 new plants were added in the pond. So if the question is given, you find out what is the birth rate, then you have to put the formula. So that is the number of new plants added, that is 8. And what was the original population size? So that was 20. So 8 divided by 20, the answer is 0.4 offsprings per year. Similarly, if the death rate is given, then you have to put the formula number of death divided by the total population, so you will get the answer. Next attribute of population is sex ratio. Sex ratio means percentage individuals of male and female. If you are taking one population, then you can find out what is the number of the male in that population and what is the percentage of the female. For example, suppose in a population there are 60% of the male are there and 40% female are there. So that is called sex ratio. And it is very important to find out the sex ratio also, because you can get the sex ratio of different states. Now if there is a difference between the sex ratio, then some problem is there. Because the number of the male and the female, it should be equal. If the number of the female is too less and the number of the male is more, then you can find out it will be difficult for male to get the female to marry. So the sex ratio, so that is also another important attribute of the population, and the government is also taking the record of sex ratio of all different states which are there in India. Then the age, so that is another attribute, number of individuals of different age group. Because census, so that is the, that is done after 10 years. After interval of the 10 years, you can find out there is census from the government. And the government is taking a record of what is the size of the population, or what is the number of individuals in the population, what are the different age group population they are there, what is the ratio of the male and the female. So all the information is taken by the government, so that the government could find out whether the population, so that is the increasing population or the declining population or the stable population. Okay, because all the projects which are made by the government, central government or the state government, so that depends on the information they are collecting from census. So the age group, for example, suppose you are taking the human being, then in the human being we are dividing the age group into three categories. One is the pre-reproductive, so that is up to the age of the 18 years when the individual is not reproducing. Then the reproductive age group, so that falls between 19 years to 45 years. They can reproduce, they can add more individuals in the population. And the post-reproductive, so that is up to 45 years age, so they are not reproducing, then you can find out there is death is there. Okay, so depending on the number of pre-reproductive or the reproductive or the post-reproductive, now if you are making a plotting a graph, then that is called age pyramid. Pyramid, all of you know that the pyramid, it is having a broad base and the apex, so that is narrow. For example, in the ecology chapter also, you know, there is food pyramid is there, pyramid of number, pyramid of the biomass, pyramid of the energy. Now similarly, if you plot age pyramids, then you will get three types of the pyramids. Either it is a growing pyramids, or it is a stable pyramid. Stable pyramids means you can find out the reproductive and the post reproductive numbers that is equal. So neither there is increasing population or declining population, and the declining population you can find out death will be more in comparison with the birth. So the size of population will decline. So in both the conditions, increasing population and the declining population, some problem is there, and the government has to find out what is the problem and has to take appropriate measures so that the population will be in a stable number.